Hello CSPro users, and welcome to CSPro Video Tutorials Tutorial 2, Create the Data Dictionary. In this tutorial, we will create the data dictionary for the questionnaire we examined in Tutorial 1. We begin by opening CSPro. I open CSPro by double-clicking on the CSPro icon on the desktop. This will be a new application, so I select Create a New Application, then click OK. To get to the Data Dictionary selection, I click on the Other tab, then I click on Data Dictionary, and click OK. I navigate to the desktop. For this tutorial, I will create a folder on my desktop by clicking on the new folder icon. I will name this folder My CSPro Tutorial. Press Enter, click Open, and now I am in the My CSPro Tutorial folder. I will give the dictionary the name My Dictionary. Click on Create. CSPro has created for us a default dictionary. The left side of the screen is the dictionary tree. The dictionary tree contains the record names and the item names. The right side of the screen is for record and item attributes. We will now match our dictionary to our questionnaire. I begin by clicking on the plus sign to open the ID items. I modify the dictionary ID by right-clicking on Dictionary ID and selecting Modify Item. For label, I enter Household Space ID, press the Enter key, and for item name, I give the item name Household underscore ID. The default application uses 1 for the ID length. The ID on the questionnaire is 4 digits, so I change this to 4 to match what is on the questionnaire. I accept the remaining defaults by pressing Enter. Our questionnaire has 2 types of records, person records and housing records. By default, CSPro creates 1 record. Our tutorial application will have 2 records, a person record and a housing record. We will change the 1 record that CSPro has generated to person record, then add housing record. First, we change the 1 record that CSPro has generated to person record by right-clicking Modify Record. We'll now change the label to Person Record. CSPro has created a default name. We will change that now to person underscore record and accept the type value of 1. For required, we'll put no because it is possible we will enumerate vacant households. We will set max number of records to 10 because that is what is allowed on our questionnaire. I press enter. Next, we will add the housing record. Right-click on Person Record on the Dictionary tree, then select Add Record. I will type Housing Record for our record label, and CSPro now has created a default record name of Housing underscore Record. I will accept that, and I will accept the type value of 2. I will leave Required as Yes, because according to our questionnaire, we must have at least 1 housing record for every questionnaire, and there must be only 1 housing record, so I will keep the max at 1. Press Escape to finish making these changes. Now we will add the items age, sex, and marital status to our person record. right-click on Person Record on the dictionary tree. Click on Add Item. First item we are going to enter is age. CSPro creates a default item name of age, which we will accept. Press Enter to go to the next attribute. I will accept the start position of 6. Here I will enter 2 to indicate that age takes up to 2 characters. This is because in our application we have chosen to enter ages up to 99. I will press Enter and accept the remaining default attributes. My next item is sex. I will accept the default item name of sex, the default start position, the length, since this only requires 1 character, and I will continue pressing Enter to accept the default attributes. The final item on our person record is marital status. CSPro creates a default name of marital underscore status for us. I will accept that, and I will accept the remaining default values. I am now done entering the items for our person record. I will click on Escape to exit the person record items. Next, I will enter the items for the housing record. I will now add the items type household and type roof to the housing record. I right-click on housing record, click on Add Item. First item is type household. I enter type household as the item label. Press Enter. CSPro gives a default item name of type underscore household. Press Enter. I can accept the remaining default attributes by just pressing Enter. The next item is type roof. I enter type roof as the label. Press Enter. CSPro gives an item name of type underscore roof. And then I will just press Enter to accept the remaining default attributes. I press Escape to finish creating the items. Now that we have created our items, we are ready to create value sets for the items. Value sets define what data values we expect for a data item. Value sets are used to define ranges of valid values during data entry and to define categories for cross-tabulation. First, we will create a value set for age. We will use 10-year age groups. Click on the plus next to the person record to make sure all its items are showing on the tree. Right-click on age and select Add Value Set. Press Enter twice to accept the value set label and the value set name. The cursor will drop to the line below into the value label column. Type 0 to 9 for the value label. Then press Enter. Type 0 as the from value, 9 as the to value. Type 10 to 19 as the value label. Press Enter. Type 10 as the from value. Press Enter. 19 as the to value. Continue in this fashion until you have reached 90 to 99. Press Escape to finish entering the values. A faster way of creating a value set when you have evenly spaced ranges is to use Generate Value Set. I will use Generate Value Set to create 5-year age groups. Right-click on the right panel. Select Generate Value Set. I'll give the value set a label, age, parentheses, 5 year, close parentheses. I will give it the name age underscore 5 y R. For the from value, I will leave at 0, and the to value, I will leave at 99. I am looking for 5-year age groups, so I will change the interval to 5. I will accept the default label template and click OK. CSPro now has created for me a value set in 5-year age groups. Next, we will create a value set for sex. Right-click on sex. Select Add Value Set. Press Enter to accept the default value set label, and press Enter to accept the default value set name. The cursor will drop to the line below into the value label column. Type male as the first value label. Type 1 as the from value. Press Enter and Enter and Enter. Enter female as the next value label. Press Enter. Type 2 as the from value. Press Enter to skip over the 2 column. Press Enter to skip over the special column. And press Escape to finish creating the value set. Now we will add the values for marital status. Right-click on marital status. Click on Add Value Set. Press Enter to accept the default value set label. Press Enter to accept the default value set name. The cursor will drop down to the line below into the value label column. Type married as the first value label. Press Enter. Type 1 as the from value, and press Enter to skip over the 2 and the special attributes. Type not married as the second value label. Press Enter. Type 2 as the from value. Press Enter to skip over the 2 column. Press Enter to skip over the special column. Press Escape to finish creating the value set. We now move on to the housing record. Click on the plus to open the items for the housing record. We begin with type household. Right-click on type household. Click on Add Value Set. Press Enter to accept the default value set label. Press Enter to select the default value set name. The cursor will drop to the line below into the value label column. Type single family as the first value label. Press Enter and type 1 as the from value. Press Enter twice to skip over the 2 and the special columns. Type multi-family as the second value label. Press Enter. Type 2 as the from value. Press Enter to skip over 2 and Enter to skip over special. The cursor will drop to the line below into the value label column. Type homeless as the third value label. Press Enter. Type 3 as the from value. Press Enter to skip to the 2 column and press Enter to skip 2 and then Enter again to skip from the special column. Press Escape to finish creating the value set. Right-click on Type Roof. Select Add Value Set. Press Enter to accept the default value set label. Press Enter to accept the default value set name. The cursor will drop to the line below into the value label column. Type Wood as the first value label. Press Enter. Type 1 as the from value. Press Enter twice to skip over the 2 and special columns. Type metal as the second value label. Press Enter. Type 2 as the from value. Press Enter to skip over the 2 column. Press Enter to skip over the special column. Press Escape to finish creating the value set. This completes the data dictionary. Continue on to the next tutorial, Tutorial 3, Create a Data Entry Application, where we will use this dictionary to create a data entry application.